quick. One. So now we good. We got to address some shit. Okay, one, two, three. Damn, it's like four niggas in here with white girls sitting up front. The nerve of you motherfuckers. Ain't this Black History Month? What the fuck is you niggas doing? The fuck is you niggas doing? Why you standing up, bitch? Where your man at? What happened? They got them all. Well, bitch, yelling like that, you ain't gonna get a brother. I gotta ask. So, sweetheart, you got a Negro, so I gotta ask. Y'all probably have great sex. Do y'all role play at all? Do you role play? No? You don't play escape slave in the master's wife? That's just, you got to hurry up, nigga. You on the clock. You got a white girl, you gotta take advantage. Halloween, you gotta dress up like OJ and hide in the closet with a butcher knife skin. Ah! Bitch, where you been? I love you. Oh, this white boy got a black girl. Okay, motherfucker, that's what I'm talking about. Matter of fact, stand up, nigga, stand up. No, look, the black woman said yes, motherfucker. Yes. Yes. This nigga pays car notes and everything. Yeah. Listen, I'm gonna let you know, you heard me say it, I don't want nobody to get upset or offended because I say the word nigga in my show. Because the fact of the matter is, I say it because white people, I know y'all say it. Don't tell me when y'all at home watching the 11 o'clock news and you hear about some of the stupid shit that black people do, y'all are going, oh my God, these African Americans. You're like, honey, look at these crazy niggas. Time out, look at this ignorant nigga here. This nigga got a fish tank for a wine glass. Barack Obama didn't change shit. We thought shit was gonna be different. Nigga, that's Kool-Aid. Look, you can't even walk. Look at this nigga here. That's what I love about that. Look how uncomfortable this white dude is. Right? It's like, oh my God, I've seen it on TV, but I never thought I'd sit this close. Don't worry about that dog, he's straight. If he start pulling a knife or something, then you run. But otherwise, matter of fact, let me talk to this nigga for a minute. Pardon me. Bungulum bungala. Bundayo bumwai. You straight. You know, it's funny, because when I went to go vote, white people would ask me, so who you voting for? Who the fuck you think? Well, do you care about his politics? I don't give a fuck. Do you like him personally? I don't know the nigga. He black, I'm vote for the black guy. Fuck that, we might not get this chance for another 40 years. Gary Coleman could have been running and I'd have voted for that nigga. I'd have been in the booth and the world don't move. And I know there were white people that got upset about that. I heard you talk about it. I think it's wrong that black people will vote for him for it because he's black. They should vote for the right reasons. Well, I look at it like this. From George Washington to George Bush, every president that this country has seen has been white. My thing is, let's just get the first nigga in there. After the next one, I get the right one in there for the right reasons. But let's get the first nigga in there. Because this shit was bigger than Barack, man. Think about the message that this sends to every little black boy in the country. That you can make it in this country without just being a rapper or an athlete. You can be president of the United fucking States. I gotta get behind that. We can finally scratch that off the black to-do list. Like rapper, check. Athlete, check. Black president, about fucking time, check. Next up, Olympic swimming. Michael Phelps, we coming. Watch your motherfucking back. Soon as they learn how to heat that water up, nigga, we are in there.